Welcome to Tesca Technologies Private Limited. Today I'm Ayush Jain and today I'm giving the demo of digital trainer. The order code of this equipment is 33504. Now this is our equipment. In this is our main power on off switch. This is a DC power supply 5 volt block. This is a pulse generator block with S1 and S2 point. These are the 8 LEDs L1 to L8. These are the logic switches SW1 to SW8. This is the variable clock frequency adjustment from low to high. This is a low, this is a high point switch. These are the power supply for logic probe. And these are the various sockets. And this is our breadboard where we will perform the connections. Now, first let me take you to the first experiment. The object of first experiment is LED display. In this we will show you how a LED will glow with the supply voltage. These are the accessories provided with this equipment. These are the various ICs and these are the resistance, and this is the LED that we will use in the first experiment. Now for this, first we have to make the connection. Put a 330 ohm resistance in the breadboard. Now put a LED in series with the breadboard. As you know, these 5 terminals in the breadboard, the vertical 5 terminals are short. So I'll put in series an LED with this. Now, by using these patch cords, connect 5 volt supply to one point of resistance and ground to one point of LED. Now as I turn on my system, my LED will glow. This shows the completion of my first experiment, LED display. For convenience, put back the equipment in the box after use. Now, my second experiment. Second experiment is getting a pulse. For this, first turn off this equipment. Now connect a patch cord from section 1, pulse generator. From section 1, pulse generator to section 4, logic unit, that is LEDs. Now turn on the supply. As I turn on the supply, these are my connections. Now when I select this S1 switch and push button switch, press it, the LED will glow. This is our pulse generator. This is our second experiment. Third experiment, setting a logic level. In this, first turn off the equipment. Connect patch cord from section 5. These are the section 5 where logic switches are there. SW8 to section 4 L8 LED8, and these are the position. When the switch is upward it is 0 and when it is downward it is 1, as it is displayed here, logic 0, logic 1. Now as I turn on my system, the LED will not glow as it is at level 0. When I switch my button to level 1, the LED will glow. This is setting a logic level. We can set a logic 0 or 1 through this. Now our next experiment. In this, this is a getting a clock and using the logic probe. In this, we will use this power supply logic probe to check the plus 5 ground voltage between this. We can use it by showing it a LED display. As you can see, the LED will glow. Now this next experiment, This is AND gate, static operation. For this, we will use a 7408 IC, quad 2 input AND gate IC. We will have to use 7408 IC. This is our 7408 IC. This is a 14 pin IC. In this, we will check how the AND gate works. I will connect this IC between these two parts of breadboard. Now, how to make the connections? First of all, to one, these are marked from 1 to 7, 8 to 14. Now to 1, give an input to SW8. Point 2 to SW7. And take the AND gate output to SW5. Put the 7th pin of IC to ground and 14th pin of IC to VCC plus 5 volt. Now, we also have to connect the SW8 switches to LEDs to show you the output. Connect SW5 to L5, the output of AND gate. Now, as I switch on, the input I have taken is one one, and my output is 1 1. For the output terminal, you don't have to connect it to SW5, connect directly to L5. As you do not want a logic for the output, you just want the logic for the two inputs, and you can give direct the output to the logic to the LED. Now when my both input is 1 1, the output is 1 1. When my both input is 1 1, my output is 1. This shows the working of AND gate, and you can take the various values of the binary inputs and the different output of the AND gate. Now the next experiment is of OR gate. This is the OR gate IC 7432. Now take this IC from the equipment kit. This is the 7432 IC. Now place this IC. Now the connections. First give 5 volt VCC to the 14th pin. Ground to the 7th pin. Now input 1 to SW8, input 2 to SW7, and the output from the third pin to any LCD. I take L6. Now when we switch on, when the both the inputs are 0, the output is 0. When any one input is 1, the output is 1. When both the inputs are 1, the output is 1. This shows the working of OR gate. We can take all the 4 readings of 00 to 11. Now the next experiment is dynamic operation of AND gate and OR gate. In this, what we have to use, we have to use the same IC of AND gate 7408 and 7432, but instead of giving the input as SW8 or SW any switches, logic switches, we'll give the input from pulse generator. I'll show you from one IC. I'll take the OR gate IC and show you the experiment. You can perform the same with the AND gate IC also. We have to make the same connections as I've done earlier, 14 to VCC plus 5 volt, ground to pin 7. Now the inputs I have to give to pin 1, to pulse generator 1. Input to pin 2 to pulse generator P2, and the output to any LED. Connect it to pin 3, the output. Now as I switch on, and when I give any pulse, it will show me the output. When I give both the pulse, it will give me the output 1 1. It is 10, it will show me 1. This is the working of dynamic operation of OR gate. Similarly, you can perform of AND gate. Now the next experiment is NOT gate IC. This is a 7404 NOT gate IC. We have to take it from this equipment case, 7404. This is our NOT gate IC. Adjust the pin so that it can fit in the breadboard properly. This is the 74 IC. In this, we have to give input to pin 1 from any SW switch, and the output from pin 2, as it is a one input IC, one input one output, and give it to any LED, and same connect VCC plus 5 volt to 14th pin. And ground to 7th pin of the IC. As I switch on, if I give 1 as my input, the output will be off, shows 0. When I give 0, the output will be shown as 1. 1, 0 and 0, 1. This is the working of NOT gate IC 7404. Now, the next experiment we have is NAND gate. This is the combination of AND gate and NOT gate, combining NAND gate. We have a combined IC. We have IC that give the functions of both the gates, AND gate and the NAND gate combined. It is a 7400 two input NAND gate IC. Now we'll make the connections for NAND gate IC. Now this is our 2 input 7400 NAND gate IC. Every time you have to adjust the pins of the IC so that it fits in the breadboard properly. Now in this same 14 pin we have to give as VCC plus 5 volt, ground to pin 7, to pin 1 we have to give a input 1, take it to any switch, I take SW8, pin 2 another input to any switch, and pin 3 as our output to an LED. Now as I switch on my system, if I give both my input 00, if I give both my input 00, the output of AND gate is 0, and then further it has a NOT gate, so the output will be 1, as you can see through the LED. If I give both the inputs as 1, the output of AND gate is 1 and then NOT, so the output of NAND gate combined is 0. When my both inputs are 1, the output is 0, you can see. You can similarly take the other two readings. This is our 9th experiment. Now we further move to our 10th experiment, which is NOR gate. This is a combination of OR gate and NOT gate attached in further of it. It is a 7402 IC of NOR gate, 2 input NOR gate IC. Now this is our 7402 NOR gate IC. We have to adjust the pins every time so that the IC fits in the breadboard properly. Now we have to give plus 5 volt VCC to 14th pin. Ground to 7th pin. Input to 1st pin and the 2nd pin and connect it to any switch SW8, SW7. And take the output from pin 3. And connect it to any LED. I took L5. Now when I switch on, when my both inputs are 1-1, the output of NOR gate will be 0, as you can see. If any of my input is 0, means when my inputs are 0 and 1, the output of OR gate will be 1, but after it is a NOT gate, so it will give 0. When my both inputs are 0, sorry, in this the output is taken from the first point. There is one mistake in this. The output has to be taken from pin 1 and the input has to be given to pin 2 and pin 3. Now as I switch on, when I provide both inputs as 1-1, my output is 0. When I give both inputs as 0, there is some problem in the IC. I told you we have to connect the IC properly. Now, when my both inputs are 0, my output of NOR gate is 1. And if any of my input is 1, the output will be 0. Now, this is our 10th experiment. Now, we move on to our 11th experiment, which is exclusive OR gate, also known as XOR gate. In this, it is a 7486 IC of two input. It is called quad exclusive OR gate. Now this is my 7486 XOR gate IC. As you can see, in this initially we have to give the same VCC to 14th pin, ground to 7th pin, input to pin 1 and pin 2 through any switch, SW8, SW7 to SW1. And the output to any LED from pin 3. Now as I switch on, if both my inputs are same, I'll get my output as 0. If any of my input is different, that is 0 or 1 or 1 or 0, my output will be 1. If both my inputs are same, that is 0 0, my output will be 0. This is the function of XOR gate IC. Now next experiment is to demonstrate the function of XNOR IC. Now in this XNOR IC, there's a XOR IC and there is a NOT IC ahead of XOR IC. Now in this, we will take a XOR IC 7486 and combine a NOT IC ahead of it. So the So the connections for ZOR IC was the same. Now the output of the ZOR IC. First we will take a 7404. NOT IC and connect it over here. We have to do the same part. We have to connect 14 volt VCC to the 14th pin of NOT gate IC and ground to the 7th pin. Now we have to give the input, the output of the ZOR gate IC from the 3rd pin. We have to give this output to the input of NOT gate IC, to the 1st pin of NOT gate IC. And from the 2nd pin of NOT gate IC, we'll take the output and show it to any LED. Now in this, when both of our inputs are same, the output will be 1. If any of our inputs will differ, the output will be 1. If both our inputs are same, if both the inputs are same in this XNOR, the output will be 0. This is the function of XNOR IC. And you can take the other two readings as you can see in this table. Now we move on to our next experiment, which is a 3-state buffer. Now experiment number 13, 3-state buffer. In this we will use IC 74126. Now first let me make the connections. Take VCC plus 14 volt to pin number 14, pin number 7 to ground, connect clock low to pin number 2, pin number 1 to a logic switch. I take a logic switch 8. Pin number 3 short with pin number 6. Pin number 4 to another logic switch. Pin number 5 to plus 5 volt supply, and now we have to connect pin number 6 or pin number 3, as both are short, to any logic in output LED. Now before switching on the system, make sure that all the logic switches are at 0 position, or 0 or 1. Both the logic switch should not be at 1 position, it will burn the IC. Now as I switch on, when my both logic switches are 0, the output will be 0. When any of my logic switches 1, that is 0 1 or 1 0, my output will be 1. This is the working of 3-state buffer 74126 IC. Now next experiment is RS latch. In this we will use 7402 IC to perform the connections for RS latch. I make the connections. First of all, I take a 7402 IC. This is my 7402 IC. I connect 7 with ground, 14 to VCC, 2 to a logic switch, as any logic switch. I take SW7. Pin number 6 to another input logic switch, I take SW6. Now we have to connect pin number 3 to pin number 4. Pin number 3 will be connected to pin number 4. And pin number 5 will be connected to pin number 1. Pin 1. And the output Q and Q bar will be taken from pin number 1 and pin number 4. First, I take from pin number 1. This is my first output, which is Q. I put it in L4, put it in any LED. And pin number 4 my second output from pin number 4 to LED 2, which is Q bar. Now, as I switch on my system, for various values of input, which is SW7 and SW6, I will get different outputs. For 1-1, I will get 1-1. For 0-1, I will get 1-0. Like this way, you can calculate for different values of R and S. We can have different values of Q and Q bar, as you can see from the manual. This is the working of RS latch. Now our next experiment is basic JK flip-flop. For this, we have to take an IC7476. Now this is my IC7476. Now to make the connections, first of all, we have to give VCC plus 5 volt to pin number 5. As this is a 16 pin IC, VCC to pin number 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. We have to give ground to pin number 13. Now, to pin number 1, we have to give a push generator SWP1. पिन नंबर टू, पिन नंबर फोर हैव टू गिवन टू एनी लॉजिक स्विच, आई टेक SW8. पिन नंबर 15 हैव टू गिवन टू एनी LED. आई टेक L1. It is Q bar which is connected to pin number 14. To pin number 15, Q bar to pin number 14 and Q to pin number 15. This is my Q and this is my Q bar. Now another input to pin number 16. We can take it to SW6. Now as I switch on my system, these are my two inputs. When both my inputs are 1-1, my output is 1-0, as you can see in this table. When both my inputs are 1-1, my output is 1-0. When both my inputs are 0-0, the same state follows 1-0. Same way we can calculate different outputs for different states. Now the next experiment, monostable multivibrator. For this we have to use a 4001 IC and a NOT gate IC. This is my 4001 monostable multivibrator IC. Adjust the pins. For the proper connection. Now provide VCC to 14th pin. And ground to pin 7. We also have to take a 7404 IC with this. Now connect point 1 to a resistance of 10k. And through this resistance point, connect it to +5V. connect second point. To pin 4. Connect 5th pin to 1st pin of NOT gate. Connect 2nd pin to the 3rd pin of NOT gate. Connect 4th pin to any LED out. The 6th pin of 4001 IC is connected to any logic switch. And a 39k ohm resistance is also connected to it. From 6th pin to ground, so we'll connect both 6th and 7th pin. As the connections are very tedious, connect it very properly. And connect the ground of NOT gate IC to pin 7 and 14th pin to VCC. Now as I switch on my system, this is a mono stable multivibrator. It will show me the output one. As you can see, the LED is glowing. That's it in this experiment. Now we move on to the next experiment. Asynchronous up-down counter. This is our last experiment. In this, the connection is very tedious. As you can see that we are using 7476 IC, 7476 IC, 7400 IC. So these are the connections. I am telling you directly through this manual. You can do the connections according to the given manual properly. Connect the pin and you can get the desired output. There is no as such output. There are various logic for up counter, down counter in this experiment. Main experiment with outputs are the previous ones that I've already shown you. In this last experiment, which is asynchronous up down counter, make the connections as shown in the figure 18, the final block diagram, by using these ICs, and you can set different logics for up counter or down counter. If we take SW1 as 1, the counter is up counter. If SW1 is 0, the counter is down counter. That's it in this digital trainer. For further information, please consult the lab manual. Thank you.